Hey everyone, this is your stimulus check update, second stimulus check update, and stimulus package update for Monday, August 31st. In this video, I'm going to be sharing some information for those of you on SSI, SSDI, Social Security, and VA benefits. And I'm going to be going over these specific topics in this video. First off, I'm going to be talking about the unemployment numbers that were recently released for August. Next, I'm going to be talking about the second stimulus check and where we are with the stimulus check negotiations. Third, I'm going to be talking about SNAP and WIC benefits and where you might be able to receive those or apply for those if you need assistance for food for you and your family. And lastly, I'm going to be talking about the first stimulus check for those of you that still haven't received it. Welcome back to those subscribed members of my community. Thank you so much for watching and welcome back. If you haven't subscribed to my channel already, my name is Justin and I do stimulus check updates and give financial advice. So be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so that you'll be notified each and every time I upload a new video. And if you find this content helpful, please be sure to like this video so that YouTube will share it with others. Let's first talk about the unemployment numbers that recently just came out. Just over 1 million people applied for new unemployment benefits this past week. While the overall unemployment numbers are just below 10% right now, there are still a bunch of companies that have not brought back furloughed employees. And in addition to this, a lot of those people that have been furloughed have since been laid off completely from their jobs with no return in sight. So the unemployment numbers are not looking great. However, we are still waiting for Congress to do something with regards to the next stimulus package and the second stimulus check. They also haven't done anything to renew the unemployment benefits that are coming from the federal government, which expired back in July. President Trump issued the executive action that would give unemployment benefits of up to $300 per week for those that lost their unemployment benefits. However, not all states are giving out that $300 unemployment benefit to those that have lost their jobs. Let me know in the comment section below if you have lost your job because of the pandemic or if you've received your job back in the last few weeks. So where are we at with the second stimulus check? As you know, negotiations have stalled a lot lately and there haven't been a lot of negotiations to speak of. Last week, however, Nancy Pelosi met with Mark Meadows, the White House Chief of Staff, and those two talked on a phone call that lasted only about 20 minutes, and the phone call was to possibly discuss restarting negotiations on the next stimulus package. However, after this phone call, neither Mark Meadows nor Nancy Pelosi said that much progress was made, and basically that no progress was made. Nancy Pelosi said regarding restarting the stimulus negotiations, "We have said again and again that we are willing to come down and meet them in the middle. That would be $2.2 trillion. We will be ready to discuss and negotiate." I did not get that impression on that call. The total price of the next stimulus bill seems to be the major sticking point and what is holding up the stimulus package that would include a second stimulus check. While Americans are losing their jobs, they're losing their homes, and they're just trying to figure out how to feed their families, Congress is bickering and fighting about other projects and packages that would be included on top of a stimulus check, rather than just passing a bill that would include a stimulus check for Americans, and possibly unemployment benefit extensions and an eviction moratorium. Those really should be the three key components of the next stimulus plan, and they can't pass a bill that includes just those three for some reason. They want all of their other projects and other payments to go to other individuals and organizations, as well as state and local governments. So that's where we're at with the second stimulus check. At this point, I do still think that they will eventually reach a deal, but the timing of it is really the question. Congress is back in session during next week, and we'll see if when they're back in session, if anything changes as far as these negotiations go. It sounds like Nancy Pelosi is not going to budge from that $2.2 trillion number. And it sounds like on the other side that the Senate Republicans are not really going to budge or go up from the $1 trillion mark that they have set. So somewhere they're going to have to find some middle ground between that $2.2 trillion number and the $1 trillion number. That's where we're at with the second stimulus check. And unfortunately, there isn't really any new news saying, yes, we are going to get one, or no, we're not going to get one. But at this point, it's still just up in the air because they can't decide on a deal. So let me know in the comment section below if you think we will get a second stimulus check or not. Now I want to spend some time talking about SNAP or WIC benefits and how you can apply for them if you don't apply for them, or if you need assistance for food for you and your family, how you can actually get some of that assistance through some of these programs that are available to you. SNAP is the Supplemental Nutrition Assistance Program set out by the federal government and is also organized by states across the country. The United States Department of Agriculture has resources, including links to find out more about SNAP or WIC if you can't afford to buy food. And in addition to this, there are resources on their website to help you plan meals and help you save money so that you can afford groceries and so that you can use the SNAP or WIC benefits to the best of your ability, and so that you can actually get the most out of those programs. So I'll leave a link to that website in the description below. In addition to this, there is a state SNAP directory of resources so that you can click on your state, and then once you click on your state, you can actually go there and onto their website, and it will show you how to apply. It will show you some more information. So if you are in need of food assistance, check out these websites, and I'll leave them in the description below. Check them out and see if there's anything that you qualify for if you are not able to pay for food and are not able to provide food for your family. And these are just some of the resources that are available. If you check out those websites that I have in the description below, there are other resources as well. And let me know if this was helpful. I want to share some of this stuff because I know many of you really can't even figure out how to pay for food. And I don't want any of you to go hungry, because there are resources out there that can help you, that you can take advantage of those resources. You can make sure that you're actually feeding your family. And let me know in the comment section if you have any more questions about SNAP or WIC, or if you want me to spend more time on these programs. So let's talk about the first stimulus check. I continue to get comments from people saying that they still have not received the first stimulus check. If you have not received the first stimulus check, you need to call the IRS at 1-800-919-9835. Only the IRS can give you an answer at this point as far as where your stimulus check is, why you haven't received it, and if it's already being sent or if it got sent to an incorrect bank account. So you need to call the IRS. If you get a representative that can't take your personal information, you need to call back and try again. There are representatives that can help you specific to your question and to your Social Security number and your stimulus check. But if you get a rep that can't help you and can't take your information, ask to be transferred to one that can. And if they can't transfer you, then you need to call back and keep trying again. At this point, if you have not received your first stimulus check, most likely there is a problem and the IRS either doesn't know where to send your check, or there's an issue where they assume you're not eligible or something like that. So you need to call the IRS and get that straightened out, or you're going to continue to wait and maybe won't be able to get a stimulus check until the start of next year, when you can file taxes and claim that stimulus check as a tax refund. So call the IRS, continue to call the IRS until you can get an answer about your stimulus check. If they've already told you you're not eligible, then that's a different issue. But if you have not received your stimulus check and you have not received information specifically from the IRS to tell you why or why not, then you need to call the IRS and continue calling them until you can get an answer. I do really appreciate each and every one of you for watching my videos. It really makes it worth my time when I get comments in the comment section telling that I'm helping you out, and that this information was helpful, and that I helped you get your stimulus check, or that I just gave you a little bit of hope. Please let me know if you have any other questions or comments in the comment section. And I do read most of the comments. I can't read all of them, there are a lot of them, but I do read most of them, and I do respond to a lot of them. So thank you once again for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I will talk to you again soon.